Stop! Not another step or I shoot.
Wait. I have come on behalf of the Marquis de Lafayette.
He's taken an automat for his aide-de-camp. You're no more human than the machines that laid waste to this city.
I was not given the same orders as the others, monsieur.
Just what mission has the Marquis entrusted you with?
I must meet with Abbé Grégoire.
Alas, you've come too late. The abbot has got it into his head to go to the Palais de Justice. He is certain that Monseigneur de la Fare, the Bishop of Nancy, is being held prisoner by the monstrosity that is wreaking havoc on the Ile de la Cité. But how can he possibly hope to free him? The abbot is a holy man. He would lay down his life to right an injustice. But there isn't one among us who stands the slightest chance against that thing. Not the slightest chance.
Le Palais de Justice.
Thank you. You. You are made of neither flesh nor blood. You are an automat like those who committed this massacre.
I have received no such command. I am carrying out a mission on the orders of the Queen. Your friend on Place Saint-Marie informed me of your intentions.
Alas. I was not able to reach the Palais de Justice. I fear that the soul of Monseigneur de la Fare is lost forever.
Was he killed?
What has been done to him is a fate worse than death. Far worse. But I could go no further. There are so many bodies. So many innocents strewn about the square. The air there. There was something sinister about it. I felt it poisoning me, body and soul. As for getting back to the Société, it's hopeless. The streets are teeming with machines. But the machine that is wreaking havoc in the area around the Palais is colossal. Much, much larger than yourself. What's more, the soul of His Excellency the Bishop has been imprisoned within this monstrous machine. I'm certain of it. Have you seen the flames coming from the Palais? I don't think anyone...
I, Henri de la Fare, Bishop of Nancy, ask the Lord to bless this assembly and watch over this meeting of the Estates General. Let us not turn a blind eye to the misfortunes of a populace who is condemned to the most abject poverty, for there is no greater sin than to ignore the suffering of one's brethren. Wickedness of the court is an insult to the misery that reigns in our lands. In such dark times, how can one conceive of hiding away to play shepherdess or tinker with clockwork contraptions?
What happened? You stopped moving. I feared you had broken.
I do not know. I only touched this ring.
Monseigneur de la Fare's ring. Oh, do this. Whoever you are, help him, please. Lord, let not that his soul be forever lost. Make haste, I beg of you.
is gone. All that remains is the massacre.
I beg you, leave this place and seek shelter. I have seen these machines in action. I know all too well their capabilities. I implore you, Vulnamipas, in Shors! Secretly, heed my words. Flee!
We must leave this place, Monseigneur. There's no time.
Take this to the clerk's office at the Châtelet.
Be not afraid. I am not a member of the Royal Army. Au contraire, I intend to put an end to it.
And now comes the time when the wolves are at each other's throats.
I will not hurt you. You can believe me.
Believe you? I'm afraid it's too late, madame. Those whose bodies are strewn about this square paid the ultimate price for their blind trust. Like me, they believed in their country, in the National Guard that they were urged to join. They believed in the Marquis de Lafayette, who was to lead them to victory, but they waited in vain for their savior. Look at them now. See what has become of their beautiful illusions.
How did they die?
Steel and fire, madame. We didn't stand a chance. And our wretched commanders must have known it. They saw what that gigantic automat was capable of, yet they let him cross the bridge and didn't sound the retreat. The only reason I'm still alive is that I'm a spineless coward. I couldn't help myself. My legs carried me here, where I hid, motionless. And it was from here that I witnessed the massacre. That creature, a parody of a cardinal, nothing could stop it. Soldiers and volunteers alike were mown down like sheaves of wheat.
The automat. Does it have any weaknesses?
I don't know. My comrades attacked the sphere that supported it. In retrospect, they probably should have tried a different strategy. They should have aimed higher, perhaps. Its head? If you could call it a head. There's no way of knowing.
I will go and find it.
A votre guise, madame. My prayers go with you, even if I don't think you stand much of a chance.
I will go and find it.
A votre...
Thank you. pro nobis peccatoribus nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Stay back!
Remain calm, Monseigneur. You are safe now.
What did they do to me? This dream. This nightmare.
What nightmare, Monseigneur?
It was terrible. I was a shadow among shadows. There was so much anger, despair. How long has it been? A day? A year? Oh, fire! There were flames everywhere! And death! The suffering I was forced to inflict! Oh, Lord, what have I done? Is this the hell that awaits our immortal souls? Once our time on this earth has ended, if this is true, then how are we to go on living with nothing to hope for, nothing to believe in?
How were you captured, Monseigneur?
I was with Abbé Grégoire in Place Dauphine. We'd gone to speak with the volunteers of the Garde Nationale. We implored them not to take up arms against the king's machines. Alas, they refused to heed our words, and we had to leave in great haste. After that, mon Dieu, I can't remember a thing. Those poor people. These automats were truly made in the mold of their master. Ruthless! To think, for just one simple reproach against the court, the king cast me into hell.
You owe your freedom to Abbé Grégoire.
The good abbot, I tell you, this man is utterly irreplaceable. He has devoted himself, body and soul, to the mission I entrusted to him. Investigating the king's entourage. In particular, the man who enabled him to create this ungodly army. But, mon Dieu, the notes.
What notes, Monseigneur?
The notes the abbot placed in my safekeeping. Those heretics took them.
I know where the documents can be found. I must go to the Châtelet prison.
What shall I do? Where will I be safe?
Go and join the abbot at the Société des Amis des Noirs. The way is clear for now, but you must go quickly. More automats will be here soon. The Châtelet prison is at the other end of the Pont en Change. This grappling hook will be very useful.
We've got to get out of here quickly. We're in grave danger.
Where do you hope to find refuge, my dear Rosa? The enemy is everywhere, and they take no prisoners.
Well, you saw the Pontner collapse into the Seine just as well as I did.
Ah, sir, that was a spectacle I won't soon forget. And to tell you the truth, I'm very happy I managed to escape with my life.
Vous ne comprenez pas. If the Automats aim to cut off Île de la Cité from the rest of the city, the bridge we're standing on will soon suffer the same fate.
Why would they deprive themselves of a means of retreat? If they really intend to do as you claim, why would they have to put up barricades to prohibit access to the Châtelet from this bridge?
I hope you're right, Monsieur Janvier. I hope you're right.